Hello, my quilting friends. My name is Leah Day, and welcome to this video about Quilter's Creative Touch. I've had about a week of experience working with this, and so I wanted to share my initial observations, just a few tips that I have just picked up immediately from getting started, and really just some best practices, I think, that are really important to mention. So the very first thing is, if you are new to Longarm quilting and you add QCT software to your frame from the very beginning, my first piece of advice is do all of your testing with the software off. So build your frame, go on ahead and add the automation. I have another whole video about adding the automation to your frame. So if you are new to this and this is your frame that you're building and you get everything at once, then I would advise first going ahead and build it all. I have taken my frame apart now 3 times and it is a big pain. So going ahead and build everything and get it all done. But when you start testing and, you know, having your initial get to know your machine time, always do that with just the machine and you. So after you do any kind of build, any kind of change on your frame, always turn on the machine and wiggle it around and do quite a lot of testing, just you and the machine. And what I mean by that is go back to my video on first stitches on the 21, and I walk through, you know, just threading the machine, turning it on, hearing it, getting a feel for it, adjusting tension. I was really persnickety about it, you know, tension. I was really stitching out back and forth lines until I was really satisfied with that. I then adjusted my bobbin tension when I still couldn't get good stitches. So that whole 9 yards is really what you want to do anytime that you change anything on your frame. And here's why. Because if there's a stitch issue going on, it's most likely something that's been caused by the build you've just done, you know, like what you've just changed. So here's what happened. I started getting a skip stitch and it kept happening in the same location down my quilt. So it was about 3 inches down from the back bar. It was consistently in the same spot and it was about a half of an inch where I would go up and it would skip right there. I would come back down towards myself. It would skip right there and back and forth. When I tried to stitch on that line, it would not stitch. Basically, it could not read that spot. And I was thinking, well, is there something wrong with the belt? Is there something wrong with the motor right there? And then I just happened to lean back and watch my encoder as I was pulling the machine towards myself, and the encoder bounced. And here's why. I had set my mount for the cords for the QCT software. There's lots of extra cords going on now, guys. And I had set those cords a little bit too high on the side of the carriage, and it was enough to bump the encoder, which was causing it to lift up off the track and then fall back down again. That caused a skip stitch, and it caused a skip stitch straight across the frame, which is kind of crazy. I didn't expect that. I didn't know that that's what was going to happen, but that's what I was experiencing. Unfortunately, I did not do that troubleshooting before I turned on the software. I turned on the software first. So the very first square that I stitch out, it starts to skip. The motor doesn't know that. I'm seeing it on the machine and going, wait, what's going on? What's going on? Why did the thread just break? You know, why did that just skip? You know, of course, it's a pattern that goes over that spot multiple times. So the first time it just broke thread, the second time the needle hesitated to go up, but the carriage kept moving and it snapped the needle clean off. I could have avoided that whole 9 yards had I done my troubleshooting, just me and the machine moving, not the software. So I really hope that that cautionary tale helps you guys understand the importance of always test, always troubleshoot, always check in on your machine and make sure you guys are buddies before you go and grab anything else, add anything else, turn anything else on. As for the solution for my encoder problem back here, I readjusted those cords, took that mount off, popped another one on, zip tied it much, much lower down, and now no problem at all. But then we did a lot of testing, and this is another thing. Every time I turn on the machine now, I come over to the side and do a little bit of testing in that batting area. And then if you're sure that everything's going well, that's when you turn on your software and get things going. Remember, check in on your machine and make sure you don't have any kind of weird stitch issues going on before you hit start and start playing with placing designs. I don't want you to experience a needle break like I did. That was kind of scary. And I certainly don't want you to feel like making this big change to your frame and your long arm has somehow broken your machine. As I pointed out, it's most likely not the software. It's most likely something to do with the build and the change, the physical hardware change to the frame. And we've just got to check in and troubleshoot and take our time. Always remember, guys, needle placement, getting that needle seated properly, facing the correct way, your threading path, it has got to be correct. I can never say that enough. It has got to be 100% correct on a long arm. There is no way that it will stitch properly if your threading is not exactly right. Your bobbin, check in on your bobbin. Make sure you don't have dust bunnies down in the bobbin case. Always, before you get started stitching, give your machine a little oil. It's going to love you so much more for it, and it's going to work with you so much better. So I hope that this video has helped you.